Next, I'll install the X-axis motor. I'll be mounting it in this position here. I'll use 4 1-inch screws, 1/4-inch screws, and 4 standard nuts. I'm going to take advantage of this cross-L hole to route my wires to the outside. There's so many cross-L holes all the way around that one is really not needed, so you can take advantage of that and then we'll eventually route it out to the electronics. Now we're ready to put the 1/2-inch rod into these bearing holes, and I'm going to be putting a bearing at this end and a rigid coupling at that end. You probably won't need another bearing in between, but there are spaces there for you to use if you do need them. I'm only going to be putting one bearing here and the rigid coupling over there. You don't want to tighten this too much, because these can break. The rod is really close to the diameter of the bearing, so you may need to sand it a little bit. I didn't sand this one. I'm able to get it in, but you might have to. The drive sprocket goes on in this orientation, where the hub is out. This is the hub, and this is the sprocket. So just put it out and try to eye it with the idler sprocket below. Align it as well as you can, and then tighten. We're finished with this. Now we can install the other rod. To put the final idler sprocket in this location, we'll need a 2-inch, 3/8-inch screw. Just put it through this hole. You'll need a washer, a thin washer, and the idler sprocket, and then a nut. We can do the same thing to the other side. Now that we know the position of the chain and, well, the sprockets and the chain with respect to this piece, we can go ahead and mount the chain mount and fasten it to the table. We'll be drilling 3 holes and then fastening it with screws and nuts. Use 3-inch screws and standard nuts. Now we can do the remaining mounts on each corner. Now we can install the chain. Now that we have the mounts established, we can go ahead and put on the eye bolts and the chain. take an eye bolt and, just like on the y-axis, just thread it a little bit so we have as much sticking out as possible. We'll take the chain and route it underneath into the eye bolt. First putting on the hose clamp. And you don't need much chain going through. Then tighten the hose clamp. Okay, pull it so you know that it's got a good length hold. Tighten it up just a little bit more. That's a very strong hold. So you're gonna route it to the gantry side. This will go underneath the idler sprocket, then over the drive sprocket, and then underneath this idler sprocket. We're gonna have to go through this hole. I'm just gonna take the chain and just drag it all the way through. And then we'll go on to the next mount. Take the eye bolt, thread on a nut, get the chain, put the hose clamp on. I'm gonna go over the top of this eye bolt. Probably isn't any specific reason for this, but I have a lot of chain left over, so I want it to be hanging down. I could just cut the chain as well and try to get it as tight as possible, and we can further tension it with the eye bolts. Pull it to make sure it's got a good link, and then we can tension it with our hands. Tension a little bit over here and then a little bit over there on the other side. It's very, very tight, and there is no deflection on the rod in the gantry. Now we'll do the same thing to the other side. The hose clamp. I'm going to go on the top of this. When doing this side, you want to try to get the chain as tight as possible. You can see there's a little bit of black here. But getting this as tight as possible with respect to the drive sprocket will make it easier for you to square the table or square the y-axis with respect to the x-axis later on. Okay, so to square the entire machine, we're going to be adjusting each. We'll be adjusting the eye bolts. We're shifting the eye bolts one way or another to actually shift the y-axis with respect to the x-axis. So we'll go through that procedure next.